Number one, we said the thalatha al-kutub al-ma'asur, that the three opinions or three fundamentals. Number two, al-bu'd an al-hawa wa tajarrud lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, to be away from any kind of desire, and your decision should be on the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. Meaning, الهوى في القرآن لا يأتي إلا مذموما. The desire in the Quran, always Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala insult, is a wicked. That is the desire in the Quran. والكفار والمنافقين دائما متبعين الهوى. The kuffar and disbelievers and the hypocrites, they always follow the hawa, the desire. Even the people of Quraysh. You know the people of Quraysh? They believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when they ask him about the idols, what they are worshipping, what they say? قال, what is this idol, al-asnam التي تعبدونها? قالوا, it's an asnam, it's an idol, but what is the mission of the idols? ليقربونا إلى الله زلفا. To make us close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they believe in Allah, but their hawa, their desire, their personal interest, they make him reject the message of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, whoever put حب الدنيا, the love of the dunya, or whoever put hold, يتمسك بالرئاسة, hold that leadership, he want to be a president here, or a leader here, or a shura member here or there, and whoever put the position or authority before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that person is a loser, wal'iyadu billah. Whoever put the envy or arrogant or hating the people or taking the rights of the people, that person following the hawa, the desire, his personal interest. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always insult and warning the people, they're following things like this in the Quran. But when the person have the knowledge, my dear brothers and sisters, this beautiful knowledge, following the steps of the Sahaba, or Tabi'in, or Tabi'i Tabi'in, that person will never be misled, because the Sahaba and Tabi'in and Tabi'i Tabi'in, they follow those steps. They went actually through trials and tribulation, you cannot even imagine, with the knowledge they pass it. They pass it successfully. Number three, التثبت في النقل. Say, always check the sources of the things you are dealing with. The authenticity of those sources from where? Meaning, now the internet, the media, TV, radios is there. Sometimes we hear a statement and we just follow that statement. You just believe it. Listen to this ayah, my dear brothers and sisters. And inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, tonight we're going to speak about this ayah in more details. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا. Allah Azza wa Jalla, when he said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, oh you who believe, we must open our ears and our hearts and our brain and our eyes, that because Allah Azza wa Jalla is speaking to me. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَإٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا أَن تُصِيبُوا قَوْمًا بِجَهَالَةٍ فَتُصْبِحُوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلْتُمْ نَادِمِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, oh you who believe, if a liar, evil person, comes to you with any news, verify it, lest you should harm people in ignorance, and afterward you become regretful for what you have done. Let's speak about the reason of revelation of this ayah, my dear brothers and sisters. One village, one certain people become Muslims. After 1 year, they are happy, they want to pay zakah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent someone to pick up the zakah to those people, from those people, to get the zakah. Of course, Those people, they know that that man, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, sending someone to collect the zakah. And those people, they are extremely happy. They make celebration to welcome that man, the one the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم sent to them. And with the celebration, they went outside the border of their village, waiting for him to come. My dear brothers and sisters, the man, that man, the messenger of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that man, he saw the people coming. What he thought? They are coming to attack him or to kill him. And he ran back. He went back running to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, telling the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya Rasulullah, innama jama'u li liyaqtuluni, waqad jama'u laka liyaqtuluk. Those people, they are gathering, they want to kill me. And O Messenger of Allah, they want to kill you too. Prepare yourself to those people. But this is not true. This man, out of fear, he saw the people coming to welcome him, to give him zakah. But you know those tribe, they said, let's proceed to Medina and give the zakah to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they went to Medina. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sent some group to see those people. Who are those people? And he told Khalid ibn Walid, before you attack those people, see if they pray or not. See, the indication of what? Of Iman or Islam is the prayer of the Salah. And they make an Adhan for the Asr, and they pray Asr. Say, Khalid says, they are among us. Say, what happened? And they explained to him. They went to the Prophet, they give the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the zakah, and even extra sadaqat. Extra sadaqat and charity. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed those ayat. See, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we have to, you hear a story from one part, you have two ears. Listen from both parties. Especially you make conciliation between husband and the wife. You cannot hear one part. One, you have to hear both parties, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, to make your final judgment. Number four, at-tabsir. Check what is the people saying in clear picture before you make your own judgment. Before you accuse the people they are kuffar, before you accuse the people they are mubtadi'a, before you accuse anybody, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, you have to put things in a scale, in a standard. First, who are you to judge the people? You have to put yourself, judge yourself before you judge the others. You need knowledge for that. To judge the others, they are mubtadi'a or kuffar or this sect or that sect. Except one group, and I say that because I'm in Australia. And that group called it Al-Ahbash. لعنة الله عليهم وعلى من اتبعهم أجمعين. آمين. Those الأحباش, group of الأحباش, my dear brothers and sisters, they are not مبتدعة only, they are كفار. They are كفار because they say it clearly. They're making part of the صحابة كفار. أحمد بن جميع كفار. ابن القيم, they accusing those great scholars, they are كفار. So they are out of the picture. Worse than any other millah. You can even imagine those people. But now, my dear brothers and sisters, among us, if the person praying some certain way different than the way you pray, does not mean that person is wrong. Clarify before you do or accuse anybody with anything. My dear brothers and sisters, number five, al-hadar min al-dhulm wal-udwan. Number five, be careful of being injustice or transgressor against someone. You be careful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ شُهَدَاءَ لِلَّهِ وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ الْوَالِدَيْنِ أَوْ الْأَقْرَبِينَ. Oh, you who believe, stand out firmly for justice as a witness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though it is be against yourselves or your parents or your kinship. Just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his name Al-Adl. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's just. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Adl. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ghafoor and Ghaffar. And you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to follow those steps too. Especially with your own family. Especially with your own family, your wife, your husband, your son, your daughter. That's why I said clearly last night, if you don't have an Islamic environment for your son and your daughter, that means you are unfair with your son and your daughter. You are unjust with your son and your daughter if you have no safe environment for them. And public school is definitely is not the safe environment for your son and your daughter. Definitely not. In fact, you put your son and your daughter in the middle of the fire. In the middle of the fire when you put your son and your daughter in a public school. Simple. Number six. Very important, number six. Al-hubb lil-islah bayna al-nas. Love. And your aim, your goal, and your target to reunion the Muslims together. Join the Muslims together. Not division. Get the Muslims together, my dear brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا خير في كثير من نجوى إلا من أمر بصدقة أو معروف أو إصلاح بين الناس. Say Allah, there is no good in the most of their intentions except who order sadaqah, charity, or righteous deeds, or conciliation between mankind, between the people. Especially now, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. Especially now, we must get together, not division, between the Muslim ummah. Because if you are united, you will never be defeated. If you are united, no one will harm you or hurt you, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. No one have a courage to speak about you one single word. And we see that more often, every place. Every place. That's why I advise you here, my dear brothers and sisters, be united, especially with the media. Have your own media. Your own media. Have this kind of public relation with the media. You choose to live here, and you choose to be a Muslim, then be strong, and be wise, and smart, and intelligent. The hypocrites and the kuffar, my dear brothers and sisters, they will never happy if you are united. Put this in mind. They want you to be divided. Their mission to divide you, to make you doubtful, to make you weak. Because if you are weak, they are strong. In the end, my dear brothers and sisters, I'm going to tell you a story. And listen to the story. Because this story, it's your story and my story. It's not a hadith. It is not a hadith. The story about a city, call it Wonderland. Or Al-Madina Al-Ajiba. You like the story so far? Or not? The Wonderland, my dear brothers and sisters, surrounding by huge walls, very high walls. Inside the Wonderland, Al-Madina Al-Ajiba, all kind of lives. Anything you want is inside. Outside the wonderland is a wild life. Wild animals. Who no one can live outside that city, my dear brothers and sisters. Inside you live normal with peaceful life. There is rules and regulation for that city. Whoever live in that city as a leader, whoever become a leader, president, he will rule the city for 5 years. Only 5 years. And after that, he'll be out. What is the meaning of out? That means he's on, that he will be killed. He'll die. Simple. Are you with me so far? The president for this period of time, his term finished. Now open the door, kick him out. And he's dead. Gone. History. Now they are hiring a new people. A new president. be hiring a new president, and everybody knows after 5 years what's going to happen. Huh? He's going to be history, right? But no one wants to apply for the job. And one day, one guy came, young man, came and he said, oh, I want to apply for the job. I said, what are you talking about? You are young. After 5 years, you will be out. You will be dead. I said, I know the rules. I want to become a president. So, okay. Zambak ala jambak. The Arab knows what this zambak ala jambak is. I cannot translate it. They signed the contract. They make celebration. Guess what? They have a president. Alhamdulillah. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, that young man, from day one, same night, he became a president. He brought around him only the good company, good friends. مثل الجليس الصالح والجليس السوء. The good friends. Say, hey guys, let's go open the doors and fix the front of the door. And he said, what are you talking about? Are you crazy or what? Open the door, we'll die. I said, I'm not going to live. And only for 1 hour, and that's it. It's okay, 1 hour, we'll help you. We will help you. They opened the door. They fixed the front of the door only. Fix front of the door. Close the door. And then have a good life, 23 hours a day. 23. 1 hour, just working, but work hard. Second day, they opened the door. They fixed more. And they closed the door and have a normal life. 1 week passed. 1 month passed. They're doing this every single day. 1 year passed. 2, 3, 4, 5. The time's up. That's it. See, they came to him and they said, the set is over. And he said, okay. He said, what do you mean, okay? You're going to be out. I said, yes, I'm waiting for this moment. And after 5 years, they opened the doors. They opened the look outside. It's a beautiful life. Rivers, streams, water, animals, not wild animals, nice animals, no kangaroos. And a beautiful life. And I said, what happened? And he said, since day one, I fixed my tomorrow. Since day one, I fixed my tomorrow. And that's what you see. And he said, you deserve to live outside and inside is yours. You are the president forever now. My dear brothers and sisters, that is your story. Is that right or not? These 5 years, your life. You're preparing for tomorrow. You are longing for Jannah. You are longing for Jannah, and you're not going to be the Jannah without a brotherhood. Because لا إيمان بدون أخوة ولا أخوة بدون إيمان. There is no Iman without a brotherhood, and there is no brotherhood without Iman. Simple. I help you, you help me, for my Iman to go up, raise. Is that right, my dear brothers and sisters? I want to leave you with this story to think, to fix your tomorrow, to fix your future, to fix your eternal life. Together, we can do it. Together, we will be, inshallah, under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. Together, inshallah, we will be in al-Firdaus al-A'la with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Are you ready? Are you ready? I cannot hear you. Are you ready? Say, inshallah. Tahqiqan la ta'liq. Say that. Tahqiqan la ta'liq. Jazakumullah khair wa barakallahu fikum. Subhanakallah wa muhammadik nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته